Prime Bayner, His Excellency Mr. Li Chao, Mr. Direct General of Estonian Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Mr. Martin Pell, and dear participants, good morning. I really appreciate this opportunity to talk to you at the Asia Forum, and I'd like to thank organizers, Estonian Chamber of Commerce and Industry, and Ministry of Foreign Affairs. I know around 80% of Estonia's trade and investment is now with EU countries. However, in today's rapidly globalizing world, you should probably look beyond your current horizon. In Asia, the center of the world economic growth today could be promising frontier for Estonian business. In this sense, this event is very timely. And when it comes to business with Japan, this forum is really a timely one. First, Japan-EU Economic Partnership Agreement. After 5 years intensive negotiations, Japan and the EU successfully concluded the negotiation last December, and the text of the agreement was recently finalized. Now, internal procedures necessary for signature and ratification should be done in both sides, then the APA will enter into force. The agreement will bring vast improvements on market access in the two-way trade. For example, on trading goods, Japan's tariff elimination rate based on trade value, the trade value, this is a considerably high level of approximately 98%. Regarding liberalization of trade in services, BPA adopts a negative list approach and basically covers all the sectors. That is to say, the trade in service will be fully liberalized, but for those restrictions listed in the respective schedules. This should considerably facilitate the understanding of service providers on both sides and enhance transparency. What kind of benefits does the above agreement bring to Estonia? Let's take some examples. The exports of wooden products account for 60% of total export to Japan from Estonia. The duties of wooden products will be abolished by this agreement, which stand at now at between 4% and 10%. Further, for Estonia, cheese is most rapidly growing product for export to Japan. The Japan-EU EPA abolishes duties on hard cheeses, such as Gouda and Cheddar. In addition, I heard Estonian side has interest in exporting beef to Japan. EPA will enable the EU to substantially increase its beef export to Japan, since the duties will be decreased from 38.5% now to 9%. As for the service, since Estonia's advance in the IT sector, IT-related service could get a new opportunity through the EPA. The Chinese ambassador mentioned that China is now the second biggest economy. It's huge size. Japan is also the world's third biggest economy with 127 million population. I'd like to recommend you to study diligently now what kind of possibilities the EPA could open to your business. For the time until enter into force of the agreement could be short, as we strongly hope. But I'd like to stress that Japan is interesting not only as a market, indirect investment, so FDI, to Japan is rapidly growing. The FDI balance has been recording all-time high for the last three consecutive years. And the FDI balance at the end of 2016, that is actually the newest statistic, increased 12.4% from the previous year. That is really remarkable achievement. The Japanese government has been doing the utmost effort to make Japan the best place for doing business. And I think that this rapid increase of the FDI is one of the clear signs that our efforts have real success. From Estonia also has very successful examples, such as TransferWise, Linguist, name just a few. As for FDI, particularly remarkable is the fact that more and more foreign companies make investment in Japan to establish the R&D bases. Because of the rapid easing of the relevant regulations in Japan, I may mention, for example, the German famous company Bosch made their third international R&D base in Japan after Germany and America. Why not Estonia? I think Estonian business should also examine the possibility that you could cooperate with Japanese partners to invest money to make a new product or a new service. In this regard, I mean that related to the investment into Japan, I'd like to mention that the tax treaty between Japan and Estonia, which was signed last summer, is now delivering by the Japanese parliament. I know that Estonian side already done it. So after we get the approval of the Japanese parliament, then this tax treaty will enter into force. And the Japanese and Estonian investment in respective countries. I think that you probably know that January this year, Prime Minister Abe visited Estonia. He came with business delegation of several industry bosses and almost the same number of the CEOs of Japanese leading IT companies. My Prime Minister, Mr. Abe, stated in his meeting with your Prime Minister at us that Japan would like to promote bilateral investment economic relations. As a follow-up of PM's visit, JETRO, which is an equivalent organization in Japan to the Enterprise Estonia, is organizing one official business meeting of about 30 Japanese companies, which is visiting Estonia this September. So there are many positive moments